I remember being told by my tutors, it's very important to fail. Fail fast, fail often, and to fail early. You never get it right the very first time. Idea one was rubbish. Second try was rubbish. Third try was rubbish. Fourth one, starting to get there. It takes a long time to get to something that you're proud of, and more often than not, you don't actually get to that finished product unless you've made mistakes early on. And it makes it that much more worthwhile when you do get it. Right now we're on the HMS President. It's a little bit different. It's great to be somewhere where you can actually have a workshop space right in the center of town. And it's also quite affordable. We're right in the belly of the beast, in the hull, and we love it. AutoMist came from a group project while I was studying at the Royal College of Art. We set about a brief where we wanted to save lives in an emergency situation. We went down to the local fire brigade, and the more experienced guys, what they would do before they enter a room is they would turn their hose to the mist setting and then give it a couple of blasts. And what that did was bring down the temperature in the room and help suppress the fire. We thought, wow, what a great piece of technology. How can we bring that into the home? AutoMist is designed to be discreet and blend in with the kitchen environment. The first thing to do is to attach the nozzles. You screw them into the ports that you want to project mist from. You pop on the outer cover, make sure the caps are in place. Next comes the tap, the high pressure hose, which is connected to the spray head. Finally, use the clamp on the underside of the tap to hold everything together. The system is triggered by a heat alarm. These caps burst open and the nozzles create the fog as the high pressure water is jetted out of the spray head. All you have to do is flood the volume with water mist, and the fire acts like a pump and it draws in the mist particles in the bottom. The water mist turns to vapor, and in doing so it displaces the oxygen, and then the fire will extinguish itself. One of the things I really like about engineering is it can have a very big impact on the world. It's not hard to get up in the morning, and it's great to be able to have that as a driver, as a motivator as to why to work. And very often with other careers, you're just sort of a cog in a larger system. You spend the majority of your time at work, so you might as well do something that you're passionate about and that you love.